Time with Jerry McKee. We've got a couple of special guests for you today, and you've probably seen them out on the corner there as the justice for the unsolved cases, a lot of unsolved cases in Union County. And we're going to talk about the voices for the voiceless, and so we're going to talk a little bit about that also. And I hope that you stay tuned. And if you got any questions, we're going to have a number up here that you'll be able to call in to ask a question. And I'm Jerry McKee, and we're going to go to our sponsor, La Fagata.
Fagata Mexican Restaurant, 441 North Duncan Bypass, Union, South Carolina, 864-429-4043. La Fagata, your family Mexican restaurant, has appetizers, child's plates, salads and soups, sandwiches, and desserts. Sizzling fajitas, Texas fajitas, shrimp fajitas. Also, they have great chicken, pollo asado, chicken tenders, Polo Loco, and many more. If you like seafood, they have that also. Fish tacos, shrimp cocktail. They have many combinations that you can choose from in different price range. Matter of fact, they have 35 different ones. If you're a vegetarian, that's right, they can accommodate you also. Lunch menu, they have the Speedy Gonzales and about 13 others that you can make a combination with. That's La Fagata. La Fagata Mexican Restaurant. 441 North Duncan Bypass and Union, South Carolina. 429-4043.
One. Well, we're back, and let me let you know that you can call in 864-441-9382 if you want to call in and have a question. And I will put this number up there for you to look at. Now you're looking at them. My face is off there. Thank goodness, right? And how y'all doing today?
We're doing great.
Besides getting stopped by trains, and yeah, when you come through the country, and you know, you're coming this way, trains are going to stop you, and you're always going to have that one person decide, I'm going to the store, and it's going to take me 2 days to get there because I'm driving 5 miles an hour.
Yes, right. Yes, sir.
I run across that all the time. Well, introduce yourself.
Hi, my name is Mary Jo Justice.
Hey, my name's Sarah DePrater.
All right. And you know what? When I first put the advertisement out there before we had to change some things around because I think one of the kids got sick or something, I had the names wrong in the wrong picture. That's why I said, send me the picture with a name underneath there.
Yes, sir.
It's okay.
It's okay.
So, well, tell me a little bit about Justice for the Unsolved Cases. And I know you also have a page there, Voices for the Voiceless. How did you get started in wanting to find out about some of the unsolved cases, some of the missing people? How did you decide? I know you just didn't decide that all of a sudden.
No, sir, I didn't. I've had a nephew missing. This December the 14th will be 6 years.
And what's his name?
David Colin Barber.
Okay.
He goes by Colin. He went missing December 14th, 2018. Oh, it took 2 years to get a missing person report because he went missing in another county. So there's a lot of stuff, a lot of stories we've heard, and a lot of stories that you don't know if they're true or not.
Right, and this day and time, people's got phones everywhere. Even 6 years ago, they had phones just about everywhere.
Right. Yes, sir.
And people know and seen things and heard things. And
exactly.
This is an opportunity for them to either call the sheriff's department. They can also go to your page.
Yes, sir.
And we'll put a link to that also.
Yes, sir.
And that way they'll be able to go ahead and they don't have to say who they are.
Right.
Exactly. You can remain anonymous with any information with us. We will not give them no names.
No names.
Right. And they can do the same thing even with the Sheriff's Department.
Right.
Exactly.
Crime Stoppers, you know. But closure, that's what people need is closure.
The big thing, yes.
And now, can you give me a little bit about him going missing? I mean, how did you get the call, or how did you know that all of a sudden has he ever done this before?
He never done anything like that before. He always stayed in touch with his sister, for sure. His sister, he always stayed in touch with her.
No matter what the case.
No matter what the case was, it was, I mean, always his sister.
Then all of a sudden it just went silent?
It just went silent.
Now, does the sister know? The last time that he called and talked to her?
I have no idea.
She got mad because I got SLED to reopen the case. Right. And she said she just wanted, she didn't want to be hurt again.
Right.
And I understand that part of it. But I also want to find my nephew. If he's been murdered.
Right.
I want to, you know.
Well, you're always going to have that in the back of your mind. What happened?
Right.
And we all do that. We all need that closure. And that's natural in us, you know. Is he on the beach somewhere or had a great time with, like, he decided to change it? But usually when somebody does that, it's usually they're either running from the police or they're running from something that triggers that.
Yes, sir.
But they don't stay hidden long.
Right.
You know. Has anyone told you anything that they seen him somewhere or
we were told that he was seen at the store in Monarch, the BP. Not true.
Right.
But also add in that Scott Kaufner of Union County was the one that said that Kenny Ray Puckett seen him at the Circle K in Monarch.
And we went to get the videotape.
Right.
Well, they said they went to Scott Kaufner. They went to get the videotape, and something about the videotape had already back.
It had rolled over.
It rolled over.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sometimes they do in stores, because I've had security systems like that even.
Yes, sir. We went into the store and asked the lady. She said the cameras do not roll over in their stores.
Because I know that our church, after a while.
Yes, after a while.
Because the system only holds so much data.
Yes, sir.
And back then, they just started out too much with the cloud, you know.
Right.
And everything on the cloud and things like that. And a lot of these, unfortunately, some of these places has non-working cameras, so,
right.
Yeah.
And that's good that they did that. But you know, sometimes people wearing hats, people look like other people. I mean,
right.
I've seen somebody, wow, they look just like them over
right.
there. And apparently,
he has a twin brother also, but he was working at. He didn't have nowhere to go, is what he was telling everybody. He was homeless, sleeping right. in his car. His car was left running, and we don't even know what time. I don't know what time frame it was in December, but I know the people that he was there, that he was meeting, they really didn't like him. And I think he was sitting in his car because it was cold. He had been sleeping in his car
right.
and working at the QT?
I can't remember.
It was
exactly
one of the stores right off of the interstate in Duncan. But anyway, there was two people that were on drugs that were sitting on the sidewalk, and they said the car had been running for an hour, and they decided to get in it, and they stole it, And, well, they got pulled over on the interstate for doing something. So the guy had a bench warrant on them, and the girl did too. So they took them to jail. But they had nothing to do with my disappearance of my nephew. They only stole his car.
Right.
Now the car, it was impounded. We was also told it was crushed.
And then we was told that it wasn't crushed. So we don't know.
Yeah, what county did they?
Oh, it was in Welford, South Carolina.
Welford. Yeah, I know where Welford's at, and that's kind of in between. I don't know if that's in Greenville County.
Spartanburg, Greenville.
Yeah, it's right on the edge there.
Yeah.
I think it's more Spartanburg.
Yeah, yes, sir. It's probably Spartanburg County, right. I want to say.
Right. It looked like they would have records on what happened to that vehicle.
Another thing, they said the cameras weren't working at that store.
At the QT?
At the QT.
Well, we don't know if it was the QT.
Right.
Because I was told it was a different store too. See, we're going off hearsay because we can't get the whole family together to even discuss what even happened or supposedly happened.
Is there any way that you can get the, because usually, unless it's an open case, of course, you can get the freedom Freedom Act of Information, mm-hmm. Information Act, and that you can able to get that information from the Sheriff's Department from what they write up. Because I know a lot of times I get received here from the Sheriff's Department mm-hmm. Press releases and arrests, and it tells me kind of detail what the officer see and stuff like that.
Okay.
But it looks like that you can go to the Sheriff's Department for them to look up that particular case that, you know, what was the officer's on scene, mm-hmm. what information he got,
mm-hmm.
because it's not a HIPAA thing or nothing like that.
Right.
And if they're, of course, investigating something besides being missing, then that might be different.
Right.
But if it's a closed case, you can still get that.
See, when I got in touch with a good guy that I went to church with for a very long time, he works in the Union County law enforcement, and he recommended me to a SLED agent, Agent SLED McGraw, and he's been terrific. He's mm-hmm. he's been handling everything great. In fact, he was on the Murdoch trial, and he called me right when I called him. He called me straight back, and he told me that he had thought he was told Collins' case was solved and closed out.
Okay, then you should be able to get that information.
Okay.
It's that way.
Okay.
And also, there's a group out of Packlet, and one's out of Greenville like that, that does missing persons. They go hunting for them.
Wow.
See, we was just talking about that.
Yeah. That's something we're trying to look into.
I'll send you the link.
Okay.
And who the guy is.
Yes, sir.
And how to contact them.
Yes, sir.
Because they got a Facebook page and a website and YouTube that they go and they go hunt, and they look in places and show people that, okay, this is where the last place he'd been, and so they kind of get a little bit more involved. Of course, I do because that's what they do.
Yes, sir.
And it's called Loud something that I have to look at it and see. But I'll send you the link.
Loudwater.
Loudwater, yes. And they and them guys are pretty good because if I'm not mistaken, one's used to be a detective, used to be on the force.
Yes, sir.
So you know that might be an avenue there that they might take some interest in.
So I'm friends with Loudwater already on Facebook, but I didn't know they'd done that kind of particular stuff.
Yes, they do.
Okay.
And then if you look on YouTube and some of the places, you'll see some of the videos where they go and where they talk to people just like I'm talking to you, where they get more information, and they'll take a look into it and see what's going on. So that might be an avenue there to kind of to help you on that end.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
And so we need to... And let me see right quick here. Get a different one up here. I thought I had your nephew's name on. Did you send me a picture?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
Was it? let me see here. No, is Kyle spelled different?
It's the one in the middle.
Right here. David Collin?
Yes.
Okay. All right, I'm going to switch the picture over to you. And David Collin Barber in the center. He's been missing since December 14th, 2018. So if anyone knows anything, you see this picture here. Kind of memorize a little bit. And if you know anything, I mean, we'll have a link on here. Send me a message, and I can get a message to somebody another. So we can get some closure.
Yes.
And you know, that's what we're here for, just to get closure, to find out who's where. And if anybody knows, please, you can call 864-441-9382 if you have any questions also. Now, not only with your nephew that you're kind of exposing and wanting, and we're going to get back to that in just a minute, where
yes.
We could talk about those folks and how you got involved with them, too.
Yes.
Right after this.
La Fagada Mexican Restaurant, 441 North Duncan Bypass, Union, South Carolina, 864-429-4043. La Fagada, your family Mexican restaurant, has appetizers, child's plates, salads and soups, sandwiches, and desserts. Sizzling fajitas, Texas fajitas, shrimp fajitas. Also, they have great chicken, pollo asado, chicken tenders, pollo loco, and many more. If you like seafood, they have that also. Fish tacos, shrimp cocktail. They have many combinations that you can choose from in different price range. Matter of fact, they have 35 different ones. If you're a vegetarian, that's right, they can accommodate you also. Lunch menu, they have the Speedy Gonzales and about 13 others that you can make a combination with. That's La Fagada. La Fagada Mexican Restaurant, 441 North Duncan Bypass and Union, South Carolina, 429-4043.
Okay, we're back, and we've been talking about your nephew, and we want to talk about another young lady who's missing in Monarch for about a couple of months. She's 31 years old, and tell us a little bit about her.
Well, when she went missing, we made flowers for the fair to give out. We put her picture up also. I also got word that I had went to a friend's house, and there was a girl there. Never did get her name or anything like that, but she was saying that she had kept Jana since she was like 3 years old, and that they had pinged her phone, and she was at
Ocean Boulevard,
and they were supposed to be going looking for her the next day.
When was this?
This has been like 3 weeks ago.
Okay.
We still haven't heard anything. They still haven't found her. She's still out there missing.
Have they got flowers out?
Yes, sir.
And she's on the missing person
registry? Yes.
Okay. I'm sorry, people. I don't have a picture up for her right now, but you'll be able to go to these ladies' Facebook page, Mary Jo's, and also the Voices of the Voiceless.
Yes, sir.
And Justice for the Unsolved Cases. I don't know if you have a page on that or not, but that's just your
that's
your
just
calling.
Our,
yeah, that's just our shirts.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
And so she went missing about a month now or two?
It's been going on 2 months.
About 2 months? Okay. Is she married or she?
She's got two kids.
She's got kids, but she's not married.
Okay, so she just left her kids behind, or
that's a touchy subject because we don't know really what's going on. Like Denise said, all these missing people, it goes way deeper than Union. It's way deeper than Union. I mean, we don't know what happened. We don't know where she is.
Her family. Is her children still? Who's her children?
I don't know. I don't know how old they are. I think they're younger though.
Okay, because that's, you know, for a mother just to walk away.
Mm-hmm. Is very unusual.
To leave her children, and I just, like I said, some unanswered answers, but people, if you see, and if you go on their Facebook page and look at this picture, and be able to see the girl. And if you see her, I mean, everybody goes to the beach. So mm-hmm. if she's on Ocean Boulevard yes, around the beach, if she has credit cards or anything like that, they can look at that.
Yeah.
So I'm sure that someone's looking in to if they found this, any evidence of foul play. Because anytime you go, like even to the grocery stores, you got these cameras.
Yes, sir.
If you get gas, you got cameras
yes,
out
sir.
There.
Yes,
yeah.
sir.
So you got a trail there if she's using her credit card,
mm-hmm.
because it's kind of hard to get another credit card into another name, I would imagine.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
And without having some kind of flag growing up there.
Right.
And so it just kind of blows my mind as a mother of two that just kind of disappears.
Exactly.
Me too.
That's what Denise it's was. Just,
and she was from Monarch too. Somebody yes, like coming from Monarch over there.
Yes, sir.
It is terrible. I tell you, it is really terrible.
And this little small town, if you look up the people, like I put on Facebook page of people, they were going back to 1999 cases. Like mm-hmm. cold cases, this on, and I was like, "Wow, all these cold cases, and just this little small town."
Right, and the per capita, that's pretty high because we look at some of the even the crime rate for small towns. You
yes,
know,
sir.
It's not like the bigger town, you got bigger things like it. But even if you have something small
yes,
here,
sir.
Right,
it's really big.
Right,
yes, sir.
So we're hoping people, and give her name again.
Jenna
Steins.
Jenna Steins, and she's 31 years old. And can you give a description from her picture?
Yes, sir. She is, hold on 1 second. Give me a second to pull it up. I'm sorry.
That's okay. And you can call 864-441-9382 if you have any information that you want to share or to ask.
She's Caucasian. She has brown eyes, it looks like. Her hair is brown. And from what it looks like in the pictures, she's not skinny, but she's not fat. She's
about a medium build.
Yeah, yes. Medium build.
Okay. All right. So and like I said, if you want to go to the their Facebook page, and you'll be able to see these pictures of these folks we're talking about.
Right.
And some we got on here that we will show you here in just a moment also. Let's talk about a recent, I think, Quentin Jeter.
Yes, Quentin Jeter.
I believe he was murdered, correct?
We're not sure about that one.
Yeah, I'm not sure, too sure on that one either.
What about Michael Land?
Michael Land was murdered.
Okay, and he was, do you know any specs on how?
I know he was murdered inside of his own home.
Yeah, they found him in his house. From what I've heard, this is hearsay, she say stuff, so please nobody get mad at us.
Right, and sometimes you got to do your own research a little bit. This is just people that's missing, people
mm-hmm.
that got
right.
murdered, that the cases hadn't been went to trial yet. I think I got two arrests on one or
right.
two, but they hadn't gone to trial yet.
Right, Chris Reinhart.
Right, and so that's at least they got him off the street.
Yes,
there. So,
but one of them's back on the street.
So, but it must not have had enough evidence for him. To
yeah,
right.
Do it because sometimes they associate one with the other,
mm-hmm.
and after they get the investigation, even the other person might have to stay locked up a little bit.
Right.
To clear them.
Yes,
so
sir.
At least we got one
yes, sir.
There.
You're right.
Now, who else or do you have that's that you want to talk about that's really sticking out there? Okay.
Christopher Reinhart. I actually got in touch with her daughter. Not her daughter. His daughter. Sorry. I got in touch with her today to ask her what's going on. And, you know, to find out if it was a cold case, was it unsolved, was it solved, and there was just no arrest, what happened. And she told me they arrested two people back in 2021. Union County lied to her and told her that her daddy's case wasn't closed or it was closed and or something like that. I think it was closed.
His case was closed.
Yeah, his case was closed. And they went on Facebook Live a couple of days after they told her it was closed and said that they... I don't think it was ever closed. It was unsolved.
Okay, what's the specs in it? What happened?
He was out in his front yard from where I take it, and there was a shooting that happened like 20 minutes prior to her daddy getting shot in front of his house in his own yard.
This was in Monarch also.
Yeah, this was Monarch area as well.
Okay, did you said they arrested someone? Or?
I think she said they arrested two people, but they're out walking free. They haven't done anything about it.
Okay. I'm just wondering if, I'm not familiar with that one. I don't know if it was a bunch of people was going down the street that shots came out.
I have no idea, but.
I believe that's how it went. Yeah.
Right. I think that's what it is. And I would say that investigation is probably still open because you won't be able to get any information.
Well, she sent me actual proof where they told her that the case was closed or. It was closed and they was opening back up, and she was texting the police department asking why they closed her daddy's case and this, that, and the third. She's got proof from where they told her that it wasn't closed and supposedly it was closed.
Right, and that could be if they thought someone is, like they made arrest and they said, okay, no, this person wasn't involved, and they opened it back up.
Right.
And then they won't give me any information whatsoever.
Yes, sir.
But only closed cases, then you can get the information.
Right. Yes, sir.
So that could be, at the moment, I'm not giving excuses for anyone.
Yeah.
Like
yes,
that,
sir.
Because you got a lot involved there. And really the key thing here is the public.
Right. Yeah.
The public.
The public.
Got to
yes.
speak out.
There's somebody that knows something about
exactly.
each and one of these cases.
There is. There's always someone.
Always someone.
Because I always figure that when someone does something wrong, they don't keep it to themselves.
Right.
They got to tell somebody.
Right, right.
Either brag about it or they just got to tell them.
To get it off of their chest.
Exactly. So, send me the name and stuff. I want to kind of check and see myself and see if it's still open. Or
yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Like that. And they can tell me that part of it.
Okay.
And now we got some other Jessica Ashmore?
Yes.
Yes. Now, we did a protest. I finally got the courage up. I prayed about it. Finally got a protest. With that, WSPA come out, News Channel 21, the helicopter, we had WBCU there. We had Anna Brown there.
You.
I thank all of those guys because her remains was given back to their, they finally got her remains and
right.
they can lay her to rest.
Now, Jessica Ashmore, she was in the center there. Tell me a little bit about what happened there.
With Jessica, I really don't know too much about it. I just know she was found dead in the woods by a deer hunter. And
she had been missing.
She had been missing for about 6 months.
Yeah. Was this in Jonesville?
Yes, sir.
And kind of walking down, it's like a dirt road?
Yes, sir. Yeah. Yes, sir.
Yeah, I do remember that. Didn't they question, I think, her brother?
Her brother.
Yes.
They questioned her brother. But the mother... She says that she knows who done it, but the police won't listen to her either.
Yeah. Well, I know if the mother knows who done it and has the evidence.
Right.
And so that's what they got to go on. Cause,
evidence,
some
yes.
people get thinking that, especially if you're involved emotionally with your loved one, that your daughter and
right.
you don't like that person. Maybe they had a bad relationship. Maybe
yeah.
That's like not trying to bring Haley into it, but
right.
that's sort of like with Haley. Just this one little piece of evidence missing to get the
Truth.
The truth.
Yes. And now looking into that.
Yes, sir.
They're going to be coming on and we'll be sir. Talking. And
they're so excited about coming on the show.
And it's got to be devastating.
Yes. And, oh, yes.
You know, I have sympathy for all these families that's lost.
I see. When we was at the fair, like, every night, you know, just because they can't see their grandkids anymore right now because of this. And I know that's tearing their world apart.
You can just look at, and you can see it in their eyes.
You can just see
you can hurt. See the misery and just the hurt and the shame that comes from Union County because they won't do anything.
Yeah. Well, you know, and again, we got to have public.
We
got to. Yep. Somebody has to see something. It's got to be some type of evidence. With Jessica, even I know that they had speculations that, okay, this person did it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But until they have actual something there,
right,
that's going to say, yes, will it be DNA, will it be this? Until they have it, they can have all the speculations they want.
Right.
But somebody has got to know something.
Yes, sir. There's somebody out there that knows.
They cannot keep quiet whoever does anything.
Right.
There's been so many caught later on down the years. They even tell their jail buddies.
Because
they got to either brag,
mm-hmm,
or they've got to have some kind of, I don't know, mental thing there. I wouldn't know. I don't know how anyone would even come close to doing that to anyone.
Yes,
but
sir.
I do remember that this was in Jonesville, and what I heard was that her and her brother got in a fight about something, argument about something.
That's what I heard as well.
And then she just went missing.
Yeah.
Right.
And that's when they found her in the field.
Yes, sir.
Right.
I don't know the cause, because I know the autopsy of it.
Right.
I checked on that, what they found there. And I might look that up and find out.
Yes, sir.
About that, because that's very important. The autopsies are.
Yes, they are.
And that can trigger someone to be thinking about, yes, I do remember that.
Right.
Because we all assume sometimes that it happened this way because we know how rumor mills are.
Yes.
I mean, they go all over the place.
Yeah, everywhere.
And then when you hear about this and you said, no, I saw this right here. I saw the autopsy.
Yes, sir.
This is what this says there. And it kind of puts a different light on what direction to go to.
Right.
So, well, I tell you what, we're going to be back right after this message from our sponsor, La Fagata. And if you have any questions, please give a call, 864-441-9382. Or you can be able to go to their Facebook page to ask the question there if you don't want to ask on air. And you'll be able to maybe enlighten them on some things, too. We'll be right back.
La Fagata Mexican Restaurant, 441 North Duncan Bypass, Union, South Carolina, 864-429-4043. La Fagata, your family Mexican restaurant, has appetizers, child's plates, salads and soups, sandwiches, and desserts. Sizzling fajitas, Texas fajitas, shrimp fajitas. Also, they have great chicken, pollo asado, chicken tenders, pollo loco, and many more. If you like seafood, they have that also. Fish tacos, shrimp cocktail. They have many combinations that you can choose from in different price range. Matter of fact, they have 35 different ones. If you're a vegetarian, that's right, they can accommodate you also. Lunch menu, they have the Speedy Gonzales and about 13 others that you can make a combination with. That's La Fagata. La Fagata Mexican Restaurant, 441 North Duncan Bypass and Union, South Carolina, 429-4043.
We don't really know.
All right. We're back right now. And we're talking about missing people. People that's lost their life here in Union County. Some cases are still open. Some cases are not because they just and find out what's going on. And the public, we plead to you to come out and do this. Now, at the fair, did you have a good crowd to come by?
Yeah. And yes, sir.
Support there.
We had a crowd. We had many people wanted to give donations and stuff. We're doing this, you know, with our own money.
Right.
We don't want donations. We just want to find answers. And we had a good turnout. And, you know, we had a few that was a little ugly, but.
That's what you.
Well, you're going to get that.
Yeah. Yes. You're going to get that. That's what I was about to say.
Because I used to put on mine where people's been arrested. And,
oh, yeah.
And I put the reason and all that's in behind it like that. And I got some pretty rough slack on it, so I had to stop that in. But anytime that you're doing this and your family's emotions, it could be on either side. You know,
right.
Mm-hmm. Because you got side that's the ones that's been blamed but then got really charged or anything yet,
right.
Then they're going to be upset because, you know, wait a minute, he ain't been charged this, but you're bringing this out.
Mm-hmm.
But what we're doing is bringing all this out to let people think with your mind, would you happen to be there?
Right.
Because we've been a lot of places.
I have one that's been on my mind a lot when it happened, and it's I even have dreams about him. It's Cal Roberts.
Mm-hmm. We got a picture of.
Yes, I believe you do.
I do. I'm gonna switch that picture over to you. Cal Roberts is missing since 12/17/21.
He was found dead in his mobile home.
Okay.
The door was open when they found. When the mother was called, she said there was another lady went there before the mother got there that acts like the mother. But anyway, she got there before his mother did. And they think that it was a drug overdose, and they don't know who gave him the pill, who bought the I mean, of course, he bought the pill, but they don't know who took him to buy the pill or who bought, I mean.
Who sold him the pill.
Right, exactly.
Okay, because, you know, people don't realize that someone selling drugs and gives someone and they OD on it and they could be charged.
Right. I mean, this fentanyl is killing everybody.
It is.
I just wish they get it off the street because, honestly, it's not doing nothing but make this world turn faster.
Right. And the trouble is, now, I had a program about fentanyl. And fentanyl comes from two different places. Out of Mexico.
Yes, sir.
It's about anywhere from 45 to 50% pure. China, wow. It's about 98%.
Wow.
I've heard a lot of things about people shipping fentanyl to Union from China.
When they get that, and someone's used to taking fentanyl at 50% or 45%, then all of a sudden they take a couple here,
mm-hmm.
and they overdose. Because
yes, sir.
It only takes one lead pencil.
Wow.
That's crazy. Yeah, I've seen that on, like, the drug shows.
Mm-hmm.
Like, with the cops, like when they're doing airport security, they'll be like dressed out in hazmat suits, like full on searching
right.
bags and find bricks that they're trying to bring back to wherever they're coming from.
Right, and the powder sometimes can get on them and,
mm-hmm.
and get into the skin.
Yes, sir.
And where we have to stop this at is shut down the demand.
Yes.
Exactly.
Not necessarily arresting anyone that's taking the drugs, one thing, let's set up some things to try to get them help. I know they got to want to get help.
Right.
You can take them, put them in any kind of facility.
Yes, sir.
But
and I've seen that. But to get them off of that and get them structured to where, okay, because I've got a lady that's going to be coming on the show here that was in drugs. She's got off of them. I had another lady a couple months ago.
Amen.
That has her own business now and
wow.
doing great.
Praise
so,
God.
So it's it can be done, but we need our taxpayers. We need more facilities that's going
yes.
to be able to counsel people that's on drugs.
Yes. Exactly.
And yes.
Give them way off, a way out, a place to stay even, because yes. you've got families that will kick them out. And you can't blame them in a way because mm-hmm. they get to the point to where they're stealing from them. It's, mm-hmm. it's,
yeah.
And it's dangerous.
Yes, sir.
But we've got to nip at and the ones that bring this in, let's put them to the max. I mean, give them yeah. maximum sentence without
yes, sir.
Parole or
right.
anything.
Yes, sir. And, I agree.
The facilities I do agree with, because from my knowledge, the only thing we have in Union is Suboxone clinics, which I'm not saying Suboxone doesn't help people, because I've seen firsthand it helps somebody. And I just don't think there's a lot of resources in Union for people who are on drugs to try to get off. That's, you know, the only place that I've seen really help drug addicts, like when they're homeless or need somewhere to stay or need food, is C4 Ministries.
Yep. Bill and, he's going to shoot me if I forgot his name.
What's his name?
Brad
Goodell.
Goodell, yes.
He's going to get
you. I love old Brad.
He's going to get you, man.
As a matter of fact, Bill was on my show here.
Wow.
And talk about his experiences and stuff, too. And it's going to take that experience that someone's overcome to be able to talk to someone
exactly.
that has drugs. Because if you don't, then you're going to like talking to someone that,
yes, sir.
Oh, I don't know what it's like to be on that.
Exactly.
And you don't know what it's like.
Right.
But until you do, you just don't know what it is.
You don't know what it is.
I grew up in old school day where we just had marijuana, acid, cocaine.
Yes, sir.
Right.
I can talk to people about that because I took that one growing up.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
And drinking.
Yes, sir.
You know? Yeah.
And so I think we need counselors that is overcome.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
That can talk to someone and say, you can do this.
Yes.
And have a someone to sponsor you.
Right.
It's like AA does.
Exactly.
Right.
And I don't know what all Union has, because the C4 Ministry can only do so much.
Yeah, yes, they, sir. Yeah.
As far as, you know, because they do so much.
They do so drugs. Much.
Now, you've got the prodigal home.
Yes. Yeah, I forgot about yes, them. I'm glad you said that.
Right. They do a fantastic job.
They sure do.
We see them all the time at Kelly One Stop, and every one of them are so sweet and so nice.
They good guys.
And it helps.
Yes.
It helps. I met another lady. I go into some of the prisons. There's a women's prison down in Greenwood. And lady was going in there, and she had been in prison, and mm-hmm. she come out, and she started a ministry in homes, and she was picking up some of the ladies there
wow.
to give them a fresh start.
Yeah,
that's awesome.
And when you do that, and you get someone, cause you know, a drug addict, they don't want to be on drugs.
No,
it's a habit.
Yes, sir.
And if anybody's ever, I don't never smoke, so I know my parents and them did, but I got a habit. Chocolate stuff and sweets. and it draws me to it, you know.
And right.
I'm diabetic, don't supposed to have it. But
right.
Yes, sir.
You don't care because you got to have it fixed, like.
Yeah.
And it's not that they don't want to do it.
Mm-hmm.
They need help with it.
Exactly. Right. And you can see on some of, like, the drug addicts' face in Union, they're miserable in their own bodies and minds because, again, you got all these people in Union dealing fentanyl, dealing meth, amphetamines, whatever it may be, and they're the ones making their life miserable.
Right.
And they're trapped inside their mind.
Along with the drugs comes crime.
Exactly.
Exactly.
It becomes murder.
Mm-hmm.
It becomes robbery.
Mm-hmm.
I mean,
and
it all blends in together because I see people when they got heated a moment, get in a fight, something like that happens, okay.
Yeah.
But over senseless few dollars to get
that's
drugs.
That's what I think happened exactly. to my nephew.
They got to have that to do it with.
Right.
Exactly.
And until we get a handle on that, it's just going to increase.
Exactly.
It's going to.
And I want to say, I don't know for true, like, if this is true or not, but I agree with my daddy. Is the U.S. and all the other surrounding countries funding the drugs coming into the world? Not the world, but like
the
U.S. and
well, if you think about your enemies, all right, let's put China up there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right, here comes 98%, 95%, 98% fentanyl
mm-hmm.
that they're sending here.
Yes.
Mexico.
Yeah.
They're sending here. We're getting all types of people around the world coming here.
Right.
What is one of the richest countries in the world? The United States.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Where's the money going to come for these drugs? United States,
right.
which is going to fund wars
right.
in other countries. It's going to fund these other things. And they'll be close-knit.
Yes, sir.
Right.
And they're going to do anything they can to get those drugs over here.
Yes, sir.
And unfortunately...
I 100% agree.
Yeah. Unfortunately, they use innocent people sometimes.
And that's yes. terrible.
Yeah. And I've met around my church right there in that area, it's a lot of drugs. I walk around there. They come up and speak to me. They're, we was building a ramp right there for the wheelchair. A couple of them said, we know how to do that. They come over, help build a cement ramp. Mm-hmm. Had one deacon left the door open. They called the police. He said, one of the drug guys around here called the police and saying the door's open.
Oh.
So they watch.
Yeah.
But they are good people. They
just have a problem.
Life. Right. And I always look at one, and I travel a lot, all the way through Greenwood, being middle and light or stuff like that.
Right.
But I look at the good. What was that person doing before that?
Exactly.
What got them on this trail? And we all know that sometimes people say, well, that'll never happen to me, and then they get an operation.
Right.
And they get them some kind of pain pills.
Right.
And then
right.
they get hooked on this. And say, wow, man, that made me feel pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
And then next thing you know, they got to have something there. But they said, well, you can't take this pain pill anymore because, you know, you should be
mm-hmm.
okay.
Right.
Then they start looking for somewhere else.
Yes, mm-hmm. sir.
And so nobody can say, I will never do that.
Right.
Because you never know what your body, because all of our bodies is different.
Yes, sir.
And
yes, sir.
We all have that that craving sometimes.
Right, sir.
And nobody wants to hurt.
No,
sir.
On it.
No.
You know, we're going to go to one more commercial here, and we'll be right back. We'll go to La Fagata, our wonderful sponsor.
La Fagata Mexican Restaurant, 441 North Duncan Bypass, Union, South Carolina, 864-429-4043. La Fagata, your family Mexican restaurant, has appetizers, child's plates, salads and soups, sandwiches, and desserts. Sizzling fajitas, Texas fajitas, shrimp fajitas. Also, they have great chicken, pollo asado, chicken tenders, pollo loco, and many more. If you like seafood, they have that also. Fish tacos, shrimp cocktail. They have many combinations that you can choose from in different price range. Matter of fact, they have 35 different ones. If you're a vegetarian, that's right. They can accommodate you also. Lunch menu, they have the Speedy Gonzales and about 13 others that you can make a combination with. That's La Fagata. La Fagata Mexican Restaurant, 441 North Duncan Bypass and Union, South Carolina, 429-4043.
Do you have a home here in Greenville?
No, just here.
Just here.
Wow.
And it's when we're back, glad to see everybody coming back to us. And yeah, it's this is the studio I use in my house here. And believe it or not, I had to take everything down tonight. That's agreement with me and my boss.
Yes, sir.
So you can't leave all that up in here. I said, okay, I can take it all down.
Yes, sir.
And I try to do it in a professional way to where everybody can hear it.
All right.
So. And we talked about the drugs. Anyone else we want to bring up that's either missing or we want to, anybody wants to have any information that they have, they can call 864-441-9382 or questions for y'all.
Yes, sir.
Now, I know y'all have jobs and kids and grandkids and all that to take care of like that. How do you get the time and to do all this extra stuff? Because I know that it takes a lot to do it.
It does.
Gathering people together,
mm-hmm, yeah.
if they're going to show up or not.
Right.
You always worry about stuff like
yeah.
that.
That's the main thing that me and her worry about is people showing up.
Oh, like with the protests, we want to do a protest once a month. We just having problems getting people to show up. Sonia and Greg Sanford's family is great.
Right.
We have a few people that show up for us. They're not family members, but they are to us. It's just the Sanfords. They've been real good to us since we met.
Well, that's good because they know that you're out here working for the families.
Yes.
Some families, they don't agree with that because...
We got together. When I put on Facebook, I was going to do a protest. And she was like, Sonia was like, well, can I come to it? And I was like, sure you can, you know.
Right.
And then I wasn't expecting all, like, News 21 and WSP. I wasn't expecting them to come because.
But I don't know if you knew or not, but during the same time, they were having something in Spartanburg and Greenville.
No, sir, I didn't know.
Yes. For the same thing.
Wow.
Yep, because I've seen it. And this is when they flashed over to y'all, and they were saying, yes, Greenville, and there was one in Spartanburg.
Okay.
They were talking about loved ones and missing people and murders, cold case files and stuff like that.
Yes, sir.
And so it's not just in small town Union, which it seems like it's a lot, and it is, but it's all over the place.
Yes, sir, it is.
And being a close-knit town,
mm-hmm.
Everybody knows everybody.
Everybody knows everybody.
And so if everybody knows everybody to me, then somebody knows something.
Yes, sir.
And they can come forward.
Right. Yes, sir. It's time for them to come forward to give these families closure.
Like Miss Sonia said on our Facebook page earlier, I mean, what if it was your brother, your cousin, your niece, your nephew, your mama, your daddy, your child's child? I mean, for God's sake. I mean,
that's right. And when a lot of times people don't act until it hits home, and we hope that never hits home.
Right, right.
You know, we just had, unfortunately, a murder happen this week.
Wow.
And that's a boy 20 years old and his brother 14 are in jail.
Wow.
And it really was senseless, but yet it just shows us that we need to educate.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Yes, sir.
Educate our children.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, when I was growing up, if you got in a beef with somebody at school, like, yeah, well, you duked it out and went on home.
You're okay.
Now it's so quick to pull a gun. And
gun violence is terrible.
It is. And we'll never stop gun violence.
Nope. Never.
Because what's going to happen if we don't educate and taking away the guns, that's not going to help.
No, nope. Sir.
Because they're still going to get their hands on them either way it goes.
Exactly. Honest person,
mm-hmm.
They'll go through it. And if they don't get approved like that, okay.
Right.
Like that, they're not going to go through that. They're going to go hit the black market.
Right.
Right.
And anybody could buy any type of gun.
Yes, sir.
Now, to me, I think they should go to the manufacturers that has the assault rifles.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know of anyone that really needs an assault rifle.
I don't either.
To go hunting?
No.
Or anything with?
No, sir.
It's a killing gun.
It's for the military.
To me, military, yes. Police, yes.
Yes.
But anything beyond that, I don't think it should be. I know we'll get dinged on this stuff like that, but that's okay.
I agree with you 100%.
Because the gun is for killing.
Right.
Right.
And I don't hunt, so.
When my daddy went hunting, he took a .22 rifle.
Yeah. Well, as I understand, yeah, right, and our shotgun, and some takes a little bit bigger gun to take down some right. bigger animals.
Yes, sir.
But, you know, when I went to school, we drove up, and we had shotguns and guns and hanging in our back window.
Yes, sir.
Right.
And, you know, with no problem at
right.
all.
Right.
Exactly.
But now, they can't have that.
Can't do that.
No.
It's terrible it has to be that way, because how are you supposed to protect your families from all of this mess going on?
Well, you know, back then, we didn't have school shootings, right. did we?
Nope.
No.
Because everybody would run to their truck.
Right.
And to defend it, that's kind of like, remember the truck that drove around and sprayed for bugs and make fall come up?
Yes, sir.
Well, I lived in a small town, and we'd always follow that on a bicycle. Yes, we'd be right behind it.
Yes, sir.
Breathing that stuff.
Oh, Lord.
But the positive thing is, our school, nobody ever had lice. So that was a positive.
Yes.
So, you know, we got about 5-6 more minutes here. Go ahead and tell people again how they can get in touch with you to see some of the faces here, some of the voices of the voiceless, and ask you questions or give you some information. Okay.
If you want to, you can go to our page, Voices of the Voiceless, or you can come to my Facebook page or my daughter's Facebook page, Sonia and Greg Sanford's Facebook page, Amanda Sinclair's Facebook page. You can come to any of us, and if you have any questions, if you want to leave any information, we do not tell where it comes from. It, if it's need to be, that we think needs to be sent to the police station, we will send it to the police station. But we just want to help everybody out there that's got a missing loved one, an unsolved murder case,
cold cases,
and the cold cases, and especially this young lady that's 31 that needs to be back home with her family. Such a young age. I pray she gets back home safe.
And tell again. Because they say me and my daughter, they would be looking for me and my daughter's Facebook page.
Oh, okay.
I'll tell them. My name is Sarah DePrater. You can look me up on Facebook as Paige DePrater. You can get in contact with me at my email, DePriterSarah229@gmail.com, and my number is 864-251-4174. If you have any information, any anonymous information that you'd like to give, I don't care what time of the night it is, you can call my phone.
Okay. And then get your Mary Jo.
My name is Mary Jo Justice. That's my Facebook page. You can call me at 864-251-3703 any time of the night. If you have any information, please feel free to give any information out to us. Thank you so much for just listening to us tonight, and I just pray that they help us with my nephew's case.
And you got a cool name too. Justice,
thank you.
You know.
Right.
Yes.
Hey, Carla, who's this? This is Justice Carla.
Thank you.
And I'd also like to add to that, too. I want to give a big shout out to everybody on our Facebook page. Thank you for liking, sharing, yes, commenting, yes, reposting. I'd like to give a shout out to Greg and Sonia Stanford, because like Mama said, they've been by our side since we started this. Mm-hmm. And I also want to let Union County know that we will not give up. And we will not back down until justice is served.
We're not backing down.
Well, see, this way, if people will share your Facebook page.
Yes, sir.
It goes out even furthermore.
Yes,
please,
sir.
Please share, y'all. Y'all heard him.
That's right.
Please share.
And, you know, I know you don't take donations, but if someone wants to donate to help fund, I know they charge you for that booth at the fair.
Yes, sir.
And they charge you for sometimes of papers and stuff that mm-hmm. you get out and make, yes, flyers. Sir. And also, if they want to get and say, you know what, I want you to boost this right here. And if Facebook will boost it.
Yes,
you,
sir.
You know, you, much as this little as $20 boosted up to 700 some people.
Yes, sir.
And so they can even do that.
Yes, sir.
So, and if you got a loved one or someone that you thinks maybe in need or something like that, you can let somebody know.
Yes, sir.
And two, also, we'll be at Unionville on Main Street November the 16th. We're going to do a bait sale, and all of our proceeds are going to our Christmas float, because we will be in Lockhart and Union Christmas Parade this year.
Yes, okay, sir.
Well, I'll be streaming live in Lockhart.
Wow.
Parade. And great. Also Carlisle's Parade.
Okay.
And Jonesville's not having a parade this year.
I didn't know Carlisle
done a parade.
Oh,
either.
Yes, I live streamed them last year.
Wow!
So
we're gonna have to check in.
There's another one.
Okay.
But Jonesville usually has one,
mm-hmm.
but they're messing up the roads up there, and they can't get it done in time.
Yes, sir.
They're doing something else. So
okay,
might want to contact them.
Right,
yes, sir.
So okay. All right. Well, thank both of you for coming and talking and spreading the word here.
Yes, sir.
And we'll get this out, and just hopefully more and more people will share and share and share to get y'all's message out.
Please do.
We thank you. Share. We thank you too, Mr. McGee.
Well, you're welcome.
Thank you, Mr. McGee.
God bless you. You're a blessing to us.
Thank you. All right, folks, that's prime time tonight. And next Monday, WBCU personality Daniel Prince is going to be on. He's going to talk about how he got into radio and all the stuff he's got to do in radio besides just a voice on the radio. So we're looking forward for Daniel Prince to come in next week. We've got a lot of guests this week. We're booked up all the way through the end of this year. So we'll be booking for January. So I'm looking for people to come on and tell your story. Well, I'm Jerry McKee. You have a good night, and we will see you next week.